Important sampling is a very fundamental tool inside of rare event analysis. I'll demonstrate it using a very simple example, estimating the tail probability for a normal distribution. We'll take X to be normally distributed with mean 1 and variance 4, and estimate the probability that X is above the threshold gamma. Of course, we know the answer to this. We can simply rewrite this probability in terms of the standard normal CDF. So we will use the real value to see how well our Monte Carlo estimates are performing. We'll start off by taking the threshold of 5, which is quite small, and the Monte Carlo approximation is simply to simulate a large number of these normals and look at the fraction which is above this threshold 5. We first import the statistics module from the SciPy library. We'll need this to calculate PDFs and CDFs of standard distributions. Next, we're bringing in the constants related to our problem, gamma, mu, and sigma. We'll note that because the random number generator requires a standard deviation and not a variance, we are only storing sigma, not sigma squared. We then simulate 10,000 of these normal random variables, and for each one we calculate whether or not it exceeded our threshold gamma. The Boolean responses are stored in the vector S. And to get an estimate of the exceedance of the tail probability, we just take the mean of this vector, store that in L hat. The next two lines are simply to calculate the confidence interval width. And so our crude Monte Carlo estimate is quite rough, but appears to be accurate. It agrees with the true value to one significant digit, and the wide confidence interval reflects this. If we were to try to use a larger threshold though, for example, the tail probability for 10, we know that this should be about 3 by 10 to the -6, but instead, crude Monte Carlo will give us the number 0. This is the classic problem with using crude Monte Carlo in the rare event scenario. What's even worse is that the confidence intervals are also 0. If you consider the problem is because we simulated many normals, but because our event of interest is rare, we didn't even observe one situation where the event happened. The confidence intervals are based off the variance of our individual estimators, and if they're all consistently saying false, we didn't see this event of interest, then we have variance 0. So we use important sampling, and we'll sample from a different distribution, a distribution where our event of interest is more likely to occur. We'll take samples from a normal distribution with the same variance, but we'll increase the mean. Going back to our simpler problem of estimating the probability of our normal exceeding the level 5, and we'll use the proposal distribution which has a mean of 5 also. We can choose any number here. Because we're no longer simulating from the original distribution, we have to compensate for that. That is where the likelihood ratio comes in. We calculate the PDF of the original distribution on our observed normals, and we calculate the PDF of the proposal distribution on our observed normals. Their ratio is the likelihood ratio. Then we calculate the same vector of indicator variables, which tell us whether or not our sampled normal exceeded the threshold. We scale each of these by its associated likelihood ratio. We can create a single important sampling estimate with an associated confidence interval. This is not a particularly big improvement over the crude Monte Carlo result, because this event is not very rare, to be honest. It's seen 2% of the time. We'll go to the more rare event, the threshold of gamma equals 10. This code is identical. All I have done is increase the thresholds of interest, and I've increased the mean of my proposal distribution to match the threshold. Now we see that the important sampling estimate is much more accurate than the crude Monte Carlo failure, which gave us the number 0. Here we match the first 3 significant digits between our estimate and the true value. One fundamental difference between crude Monte Carlo and important sampling is the value of each individual estimate. When you look at a crude Monte Carlo estimate, imagine we just set capital R equals 1, then we run our experiment, we see whether the event happened or it didn't happen, and we return the number 1 or 0. With important sampling, we allow ourselves to return a real valued number here instead. It will have the same mean, but it can take values which are non-integer. This particular important sampling scheme gave us individual estimates between 0 and 4 times 10 to the minus 5, with the largest estimate being the 690th estimate.